everyone. Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to find the inverse of a function. And in this particular problem, we've been given the function f of x equals the square root of x minus 2. And I've gone ahead and written out the steps here that we need to follow in order to find the inverse of the function. The first thing we're going to do, and this is just to make it easier on ourselves, we're going to go ahead and replace the f of x notation with y. Sometimes you'll just be given the function y equals the square root of x minus 2. If you get f of x, you want to just go ahead and replace f of x with y. So let's actually go through this or perform these steps as we go. So we'll end up with y equals the square root of x minus 2. Then we're going to go ahead and switch x's and y's. And that means that everywhere where we see a y in our function, we're going to go ahead and change it to an x. And everywhere where we see an x, we're going to change it to a y. So in this particular case, we're going to end up with x equals the square root of y minus 2. So we just changed the y to an x, and we changed the x to a y. And you'd have to do that everywhere where you had an x or a y variable. So you'd go ahead and switch those two. Then you're going to need to solve for y. And this can be one of the trickiest parts of finding the inverse function, because sometimes it can be difficult to solve for y. It's just pure algebra, and that can often be the hardest thing to do. In this case, it's not too bad. We're going to square both sides. So we'll get x squared equals, when we square the right-hand side, we're going to end up with just y minus 2, because we're going to take the square of a square root. So we'll end up with y minus 2. Then we'll add 2 to both sides, and we'll get y equals x squared plus 2. So finally, now that we've got it in this form, y equals x squared plus 2, the last thing we have to do is replace y with f to the negative 1 of x, which denotes or is the notation for the inverse of the original function f of x. So again, all we need to do is, instead of writing y, we'll just say f to the negative 1 of x equals x squared plus 2. And x squared plus 2 is the inverse of the square root of x minus 2. So that's it. This is the inverse function right here. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one.